It's a very enlightening journey of this middle-class struggling Gujarati businessman, which all of us can relate to.
Working with stalwarts like Paresh Rawal and Gomal Irani, how was that experience for both of you?
I unfortunately haven't been. I didn't get a.
You are probably one of the few, or the only actor I haven't seen anyone trolling you at all. Do you receive any trolling on social media? Hi, this is Gaurang from ZoomTV.com and I have with me Rajkumar Rao and Moni Roy, and they are here for their film Made in China, which is releasing this Diwali.
This Diwali, so 25th October.
25th of October. So welcome to ZoomTV.com.
Thank you.
So, it's not really a thing to say that I love the trailer because
Thank you, Gaurang.
So, but you know, what struck me the most was that the look you have donned for this film.
Yeah.
Because Hindi film industry for most part is all about vanity and you know how the lead actor should look desirable on screen. And clearly,
Raghu is pretty desirable.
I was just going to say that. No, what do you mean?
You know, there is that, so to say, like that definition of being desirable.
Yeah, the definition.
Yeah. You know, as a movie buff, I feel represented here. So tell me about the look of the character.
Well, I wanted a very peculiar look for Raghu, and I try and, you know, change my physical appearance for whatever my characters asked me to do. So for Raghu, I saw this opportunity that where I can, you know, gain some weight, and maybe this unibrow idea came from Mikhil, because he also had this, and a lot of people in India. So I represent like a lot of middle class people, you know, we're all not everybody's got six packs and everything. And it's a very real film, it's about real people and their problems and their aspirations. So I wanted to be like one of you guys, so that's the reason I just wanted to be very normal.
Your first film was, Gold, which was a sports drama, like sports biopic, and then second one was a spy thriller. This one is again in the, like, it's as commercial as it gets. So tell me about the kind of, the genres are as varied as it gets. So when you select the roles, do you go with, you know, what character you're playing in the film, or as a whole?
Both.
If the film is good?
Both. It's always the story and the character, I guess. And within the first, 20-30 minutes of listening to the narration or reading the script, only you know whether or not you want to do it. If you are feeling interested, excited, looking forward to doing something. But having said that, actually they have chosen me. I'm actually very thankful to Dinu that he called me for this. It's literally been my second year. Last year Gold released in the movies. So whatever little that I have been asked to do, or the kind of films or roles that have come to me, I have selected from. I'm doing as good as I can, basically. That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
And I'm really thankful that Made in China came along.
Like I said, there are many funny moments in the trailer, but there are few of the things, like that final scene when he says that "Aa gaya tujhme" and all that. I'm sure that must be there in the script, but how much of it is improvised? Because those are the kind of things only I can expect from you, the way you perform.
I tend to improvise a lot. I tend to add whatever I can to make it better. The whole portion where he tells me, "Tumhare andar aa gaya, put your hands," the whole thing where I actually literally, put my hand in and say, "Ke, thoda garam hai." So the last portion was something which was improvised. And I think the credit goes to Gajraj sir, because he was so open about the idea that, you know, let's just go with the flow. And Mikhil, who gave us so much of freedom to experiment, to change lines, or to, as you said, to improvise. Yeah.
So the movie is getting this big Diwali release, and last year Ayushman told me in an interview when Badhai was releasing on Dashera that he is very happy that this is big festival release. After a long time, he's getting a festival release. And now for both of you, of course, you had Gold, which was Independence Day, but Diwali is probably like one of the biggest festivals in India. So how is that, because I think the movie was earlier supposed to release in August.
It was, yeah. Personally, for me, it's a very neutral feeling. You know, I'm excited that film is coming out, but especially now, we've seen in past also, like it doesn't matter when
your film
is coming out. If a film is good, it will find its own audience. But Diwali being this huge weekend, there's some, 4 or 5 days in the weekend for Diwali, and everybody in that mood to celebrate and get entertained. So I think Made in China serves that purpose. I think it's the right time to release our film on Diwali, because it's a family entertainer, and family want to go out and watch something which is exciting.
And you tend to get more eyeballs.
I am very excited.
Yeah.
It's a very auspicious day.
Yeah.
So literally, like time-wise also, it's very, very auspicious. So I feel like it's coming at the right time. Plus, Diwali is such an important time for, he keeps saying this, all the businessmen and entrepreneur, this is Diwali, Dhanteras. So it's coming at a time which is going with the theme of our film as well. So
that is great.
Couldn't be happier.
talking about the box office of it, I mean, I loved you in Ek Ladki Ko Dekha Tha Aisa Laga Desi. I thought you were...
Which film you haven't loved him in? Tell me that.
I'll tell you, honestly.
Oh.
Even I know it.
I loved him in it, but I thought there should have been more of him in that film.
Mm. I know which one you're talking about.
So...
I know either. Yeah.
Both?
Yeah. No, the
first one. Second one, okay.
Yeah. I think I told you also last time.
Yes.
And Ek Ladki Ko, I even told you that time, after watching the movie, that how much I loved him in the film. He was the best part. And then Judgment Day like as well. He was amazing. But of course, it's not in your hand, but those movies didn't fare that well, you know, on expected terms at the box office. So how do you cope up with that?
Judgmental still, like, I think it did pretty well.
Yeah.
Then, of course, it could have done way better. But with Ek Ladki, it was
not a very conventional subject. You know, now people are
making more film on the same-sex relationships. But about a lesbian couple relationship, nobody has actually, that was up to fire.
Yeah.
But a big commercial, you know, first time a commercial leading actress was doing, playing a lesbian
part. And done
part.
Aesthetically, not to, you know, grab eyeballs, basically.
Correct. So I think we already knew that it's a niche film and we are experimenting with the story. But for me, it was a very important story that needed to be told. So that was my whole point that, you know, it's a thing that people should be aware of, that it's fine, you know, it's a very personal choice that we make. So that was the whole point of being a part of that story, that I just felt it should go out.
Okay. So talking about the social media nowadays, you are probably one of the few or the only actor I haven't seen anyone trolling you at all. Do you receive any trolling on social media?
Well, yeah, maybe like 0.5%.
Yeah, yeah. So what is it that you're doing right? Because she receives a lot of trolling, and in fact, everyone receives a lot of trolling. So what is it that you're doing right and we are doing wrong?
I don't know.
I'll tell you, he only works and he's not on social media at all. That's what he's doing right.
I'm not too active on social media. Especially when a film is coming out and film is close to your heart, then of course you become a little more active and you want to tell your teasers and trailers, you want to send them out. But apart from that, no, I'm just being myself. I'm not trying to be anybody else. I'm just speaking my heart out there. But I don't know, you need to ask people, yeah. But it's a good thing, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Complaints, yeah.
How is it about you? Because I see people take offense in any and everything.
Earlier on, it used to bother me, but now we've been on Instagram long enough to know that these people are ghostwriters, you know? They're hiding their faces behind their screens and, like, for the lack of doing anything better in their life, that's what they do. So you let them do their work and you shouldn't, like, waste any of your time, I guess.
So I was reading this interview with Sumit Vyas and a couple of months ago, and he said that when he first met you on the set, even before the shoot had started, you started talking in that accent you were going to play. So this is how your process is, even like you get into character even off camera.
It's exciting for me. You know, it's not about just being in a character when you're in front of the camera. If on set you can still be in that mood, in that zone, then it doesn't trouble you when you're in front of the camera, because it has by the time it has become a part of your life. So whatever you're doing comes very naturally to you. So just to make it easy, just to make it very real and not by not showing any effort. So that's the kind of exercise I tend to do.
And what about you? How is your process like?
My process was with the solid team that we have. Mikhil sir, Karan, our writer, they met me. I actually had a mini workshop.
Okay.
So she doesn't have an accent because the character brief was such that she's lived in Bombay and studied here. And, you know, she's like you and me. And she'd be probably like us, but she meets this boy, Raghu, and then gets married, goes off to Ahmedabad and staying there. That shows the little bit of oddity of the couple also, you know? Like she talks like proper, and he's a proper Gujju guy. But what I had to work on was mannerism. So they gave me a lot of examples. They went through the lines with me, and then they tell me how Rukmini would probably sit, when she's working in the kitchen, how would she be? She's not as animated as I am. So yeah, all of those things we had to work on. And whatever was left, and the most of it, the person sitting right over here, I got to learn from on sets.
Last year, one of the best performances I've seen of all time is Omerta, of what you did in that film. But for some strange reasons, it wasn't acknowledged in the award. Leave aside popular awards, even the national award, you know, those kind of awards. So why do you think that happened?
I don't know why did that happen, but it was a very limited release.
Yeah.
It's a film that I gave like a lot of, you know, like really like blood and sweat to my character to play Omar Sheikh. I wish, because till date, every day, like me and both Hansel sir, both of us get a lot of messages all across the world that they want to see Omerta. They've heard a lot about, like, people from you, like, those of you have seen, they know the kind of film it is. It's a hard hitting. It's a pretty dark film, and a dark character. But I hope it comes out on some digital platform, because I don't know what's the internal dispute going on. We can just hope and pray that it comes out someday so that people can, because we all do films so that people can watch them. I just hope it grabs some eyeballs whenever it comes out.
But do you ever feel like, is it disheartening when, of course, people, it didn't get the desired eyeballs and it didn't get the acknowledgement as well in terms of, awards and all. Is it disheartening?
No, it's not disheartening. Because honestly, for me, those 3 months that when I was playing Umar Sheikh, I was in a very dark mental space. And as an actor, I was really enjoying that. I've started feeling like Umar Sheikh, like how he would feel. That's what we try and attain with all the performances, where you become the character. And it doesn't happen with every film, but with Umerta it happened. I started feeling like Umar Sheikh. And it was not an easy space to be for 3 months.
Okay.
So for me, the process was so enjoyable. I really cherished those 3 months because I could really taste something very pure in the process. And that's the most important thing for me. And then what happens to the film, it's film's destiny. There's nothing in your hand, nothing in your control. But then saying that, I still wish that, whoever has seen it has good things to say about it, mm-hmm. but I just wish now that more people can watch it.
Made in China, like the trailer, it has its moments, like funny moments, and there is also some double meaning insinuation as well. So what sort of genre we can classify this movie in?
Well, it's a very enduring journey of this middle class.
A family entertainer.
Family entertainer.
Yeah,
it's a middle,
for sure.
Journey of this middle class struggling Gujarati businessman, which all of us can relate to. We all have aspiration. We want to do good in life. We want to be something. Where we are, we want to go one step above of that. So I think Raghu is, and the whole family, all the characters, they're representing that. And in that, it's a joyride. You'll have fun. You'll laugh out. You will laugh a lot. But you will witness a beautiful story, and you will relate to these characters. You will take back something from these characters.
Working with stalwarts like Paresh Rawal and Bommen Irani, how was that experience for both of you?
I unfortunately didn't get a scene with Bommen sir or Paresh sir or Gajraj sir.
Oh. But I think that Nari Nari song is there.
Song we had.
Yeah. But you got to dance with him.
Yeah, I didn't get to act with him, I got to dance with him. No, he's such a intelligent and fun guy to work with, He is just constantly, you get to learn so much from him. But I genuinely wish, hope and pray that I get to spend some time doing scenes with him in the near future.
Okay.
But we did work with Manoj sir and Sumit and obviously Raj, so that was a completely enriching experience.
Okay. How about
for me, it was a learning experience. These are the people that I'm very fond of. They have inspired me with their performances, and to get a chance to work with them was an avoid dream come true. Paresh sir, we all know. I think he's definitely one of the most versatile actors that we have in our country. So for him, it was also like a small acting school for me, because I was asking them a lot of questions about their earlier performances, that how would you prepare, what would you do, that scene, how did you approach that scene. Like a small acting class going on also, like side by side. But it was beautiful just to work with them and just to see how they approach a character and to stand in front of them and see the ease that they bring in with their characters. I think it was a big learning process for me.
Okay, so the song has been a rage, songs, all the songs, the mainly, like Sunny Day is stuck in my head for some reason. Like it has that catchy tune. So, and the movie is releasing on October 25, like we said, and we are all excited for it. So lastly, I would just want to know, what do you have like in future, like come upcoming films?
After Made in China, I have Hansal Sir's next, which Toram is Khan. Tentatively called Toram Khan. Then I have Anurag Basu's next, which is called Ludo, which is a crime comedy. And I'm thrilled about that film and about playing that character.
Right?
That's an anthology, yeah. And then I have Rui Afza, another next horror comedy after Three with Dinu and Janvi.
Many,
and
it doesn't end. go on.
So then I'm going to start The White Tiger.
And Chupke Chupke?
Chupke Chupke is something I'm really looking forward to, because that's one of my most
me
favorite.
Too. And
yeah,
what
me
did
too.
I really?
Love that film. Yeah.
That is also a tricky situation, because it's a classic and you have to get into a legend's
shoes. Yeah, it's
shoes.
A big responsibility. We
but
all
if anybody can
that.
Do it.
Yeah, exactly.
You
and people won't mind, like I said.
Yeah.
He won't get trolled. So any update on 3-2? Because that is something.
Well, yeah, it will definitely happen, but when will it happen? That I don't have an answer for that. But yeah, it's a big franchise. We all know that how much love we got for 3, and we are also waiting to get back with the whole team and to go back there again and start shooting for 3-2.
Okay, great. And what about you? Brahmastra was supposed to release this year, but now there's no
next
update.
Next year, I think.
Yeah, but now the...
I don't know.
Oh, you don't know?
I don't know.
Okay.
When. But next year, most.
Okay,
most
summer
probably.
2020 release.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. All the best for Made
thank
in China.
Bro.
I'm looking forward to the movie. As usual, I look forward to all your movies. And
thank you.
I loved you in Gold and I loved you in Roy as well. And so, thank you so much, and it was great.
Thank you, Gaurang.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Yeah.